It's cold, isn't it? But he's loving it. This is Rascal's first day out in a long time, except to go potty, because he's had a disc problem. And I've been kind of pampering him. And today, for some reason, he just woke up and he felt wonderful and he was running around and having a great time. Problem is that he hasn't been eating regularly, so I came outside and he's doing this bulimia thing all over the yard. He's like, yeah, I know, I'm making fun of you. But he was throwing up all over the place. And but anyway, I was coming outside and I was going out to the chicken coop, because I remember last week I did a video on how I had to get rid of my birds, and I really wasn't too happy about it. It kind of bummed me out. So last night I was sitting on Facebook and just feeling kind of sorry for myself. And anyway, I came out here and he's peeving all over the yard, fertilizing it with vomit. And I went out to the chicken coop to go gather up the chicken feeder, the waterer, to start cleaning things out. And I really didn't look forward to it. And anyway, I went to the door, I opened it up, and the first thing I heard was this. I know, I absolutely did not expect that, because the night before, the guy who came to get the birds, it was at night, so they were all roosting, so we had to grab the birds off the roost. We grabbed all the birds, and it was just chaos. It was Armageddon. Birds are running, I'm running. It was just nuts, and then we gathered them up, and we heard nothing. We looked everywhere, and there was no bird to be found. We figured we had them all. Turns out this one escaped, and so it was kind of a pleasant surprise. It was very unexpected. And I went in there and I saw her, and she looked up at me and I looked down at her, and she went walking over to me, and I got so excited. One bird left. And I figured, well, it's kind of silly to place an ad just to get rid of one bird. I guess I could probably handle one bird and even move with one bird, make a little mini cage for her when I go there and try to take care of her until I get the new flock going. So I'm keeping her. Yes, I am. I'm keeping her, and it's a very good day for me. I feel really good about this. And I named her Iowa because she's going to be my first bird in Iowa. So I figured, her name will be Iowa. Rascal liked it too. He went and stuck his nose in her butt. I guess that's his way of saying hello. And he had a good day. I'm having a good day. And I decided to bring a cup of coffee out to the garden just to look around, because I haven't been out here in weeks. You know, you figure garden's dead. Why should I come out here? There's really nothing to see. It's kind of blah. But then I noticed something. Take a look at what I saw. This skinny bed is about a 1 foot by 4 foot, and this is where I was growing my parsley and my cilantro and dill. And I pulled them all up and I thought it was done. I even filled this bed up with compost. Remember how these were only like less than half full? Yep, it's full of compost, and I thought I had everything. But apparently, if you don't pull up all of the parsley, look what happens. You get more parsley. Yes, you do. And I looked it up before. Ooh, wow, there's some more. Hey, look. I looked it up. Ooh, there's more. Right down there, little tiny green things. I looked it up, and it turns out parsley is one of the most cold hardy plants that you can put in your garden. Yes, it is. So I'm gonna leave this here, and I'm sure that this won't survive the ice cold and stuff, but the stuff down there, the roots and stuff, they're gonna, and I think I'm gonna have perennial parsley. So, well, actually, the person who buys this house is gonna have perennial parsley. Isn't that gonna be a nice surprise for them? A little gift from me. And over here, let me move you over here. This is actually kind of cool too. I didn't even think that this would happen. Does that look familiar to you? Let's zoom in. Stop me when you can recognize it. Now? Little tiny cilantros. Remember the episode I did when I was harvesting cilantro seed, and I said I leave the rest out here just for the wildlife and stuff? Well, apparently some of it fell down here, and I tested this out to make sure it was cilantro. I pinched it and smelled it. There's no mistake in the smell of cilantro. I have all kinds of cilantro sprouting up for the winter. I don't know if it's going to survive, but I just thought that was really kind of neat. You know, when you think that your garden's gone and you're done for the winter and you're freezing and you want a little bit of green because you're just jonesing for something to grow, you come outside and nature surprises you. Hey, look at my little garden growing. And one last little surprise, oops, one last little piece of grass. One last little surprise my garden had for me. Take a look at this. This is the early Jersey Wakefield cabbage I grew this year. It was wonderful. The flavor on this was fantastic. But I yanked them all up, and I could have swore I harvested them all, but when I came out today, look at this. I have cabbage, yep. And I'm just gonna leave this here because, there's another one. Hey, look, over here. I got another one over here. little ones here too. I got little cabbagettes all over the place. And this will be another nice little surprise for the new owners of the home. Little things that come up in the garden that they're not going to expect if they don't get things planted right away. There's going to be a little gift for them here. Cabbage. I mean, who doesn't like fresh? Oh, wow. I was smelling my fingers while I was talking to you. Yes, I do those kind of things. But yes, I have cabbage too. I love it. Oh my God, it surprised Rascal. Now take a look at something. This is something you're going to notice on your asparagus towards the end of the season. See these little orange things? Yep, those aren't tomatoes, folks. Those are asparagus seeds. When they turn orange like this, gently pick them, take them inside, dry them out, and you can plant your own asparagus plants inside and grow them from seed. And by the way, for those of you who are new, I did plant these from seed. So these are grown from seed. They're only a couple years old, and they are extremely healthy. Oops, sorry. I dropped you on the bed. Extremely healthy, extremely productive plants. You can do that too, but make sure you give them plenty of compost. They suck up the compost like you would not believe. Give them compost first thing in the spring and they will thank you for it. Now in the spring, all of these are going to be dried and dead. So what I'm going to do is gently pull them out or snip them off at ground level, and that's all you have to do. Now, when you're prepping your compost pile for winter, it is extremely easy to do. No magic, no special science or anything like that. Take a look at that. Yeah, I had a big old tree limb fall off my walnut tree and it fell right onto my compost pile. You know, if I'd have been out here doing compost, I'd have been dead right now. You really gotta watch out, especially in the autumn when things start dying out and stuff. Yep, the wind picks up and things fall off your tree and you never know what's going to come out of the sky. But anyway, back to our compost pile. When it comes to preserving your compost for the spring, you don't want to leave it open for the winter because all the snow and the rains of late fall and then winter and then spring, it's going to leach all of the good stuff out of your compost pile into the ground underneath your compost pile. Great for the ground underneath your compost pile, sucks for your compost. So I would suggest just taking an old tarp, lay it over there, put rocks on all four corners and maybe one in the middle to keep the wind from blowing it away. That's all you have to do. There is no need to keep it totally airtight or anything like that. You don't have to do that. Just keep the moisture off. Let some oxygen in there. It'll be just fine in the spring. I have these. And I wouldn't normally store my compost like this, but I've told you that I'm moving in the spring and I want to take my compost with me. I'm a greedy little thing. I want to make sure that I have some compost to start my new garden because I want to have a garden out there. And they're, you know, it's got great soil, but you know, I may not be able to till it up and I may have to do container gardening. So I took all my compost and I put it in here. And you can store in covered containers. The thing is that when you cover them up, you may get a little bit of anaerobic action going on there over the winter, and that's okay. In the spring, you may open it up and it smells really funky. All you got to do is dump that stuff out in the garden, mix it up, give it a couple days. It's not going to smell funky anymore because anaerobic bacteria, although people will try and scare you until it's really horrible, nasty, it's going to kill you. Anaerobic bacteria is extremely weak bacteria, and in the presence of oxygen, goes away just like that. I've been doing this for so many years and I have never once, you know what's weird? I got poisoned from store-bought produce and I have not gotten poisoned from my own garden. And I compost chicken manure. I'm out here with my hands in the dirt and I have all of this aerobic, anaerobic, bacteria, fungus, you name it going on. There's all kinds of weird, special, strange stuff going in my soil. Never once poisoned myself. So I can say this with a lot of assurity. Don't worry about anaerobic bacteria. Once you take it out of these containers, like a trash can or something like that, mix it in with your soil, let it set for a few days. The soil microbes take over. Anaerobic bacteria can't live in there because there's oxygen in your soil, above your soil, and they're going to be just fine. So don't worry about that. I don't know what it is. What is that, Rascal? Is it a kitty? What is that thing? Oh, wow. Son of a gun. Look at what this crazy dog found. Oh, it's kind of sad, but look. He dug up a hibernating frog. Little butthead. I gotta go bury this thing or it won't survive the winter. Say goodbye, Mr. Frog. Rascal, you really, really have to stop digging up the wildlife. That is so not cool. There. Put some leaves and grass on top of Mr. Frog. There. We'll see you in the spring. Are you done decimating nature? Okay, we gotta go, everybody. Thanks for joining me in the garden. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day. I am. Bye. Let's go dig up a donut.